typical. 7 to 8 people over here, okay? So let's start with decouples problem and their solutions, okay? So before I start, so I just talked about myself. So I am Devinder. So I came directly from Delhi. So I'm having 6+ year in Drupal only. I work for TCS, Capgemini, Sapient, and now working for Datamatics. So yeah, so next slide is about me. So what I'm doing, that my Twitter handler, my Slack. So right now I am a senior position in Cygnus, and I work for decoupling since 2015. So let's start with the first slide. So what is the topic like? So what all topic I will cover today. So first one is decoupling and why there is a need of decoupling, when to choose which type of decoupling, and what are the problems into decoupled and how to resolve that. Okay, so like how many of you know like what is decoupling? Okay, so decoupling is like exposing your CMS data in with the APIs. So it might be like a JSON API or it is a REST API, and front end will be like in Angular 1, React 1, and other like framework like Gatsby. So what is like typical decoupled, like how you just expose an API and how you show at the front end layer, okay? So this is like a JSON contract where we have a first element is main navigation. So that is the first element. There is a term ID, that is a taxonomy based structure where we have two items, home and marquee data. So home is nothing like, it is a first item into the main menu, we can say. So here is the front end. So what React team is doing is just calling a particular API. It's having a path is like API CMS path slash API slash main nav. Okay, so you will get all the JSON, all the parent and child. And if I am having any item under home, then there is in the items array that there should be another array which is showing home, and there is something about us, something like that. So in this typical way we doing decoupling. And apart from it, I'm using taxonomy as a menu because we can easily embed new fields into taxonomy and easily expose into the API. So if I using a menu tree, so there is some problems into that. So I need to add some custom field into menu items. That is a little tricky. So if I talk about name is home, URL is slash. So I can about us page, I can make it like a URL is slash about hyphen us. So if I talk about market data, similarly, I can make my URL according to that. And if someone is clicking on home or market data, that will navigate to particular URL that is mentioned over in this API. So that is like a typical way, like how we can do making an header, making an footer, making an page. Okay, so yeah, so before moving into that, why we need this kind of decoupling? So I have created a Drupal site, but I just want to create an mobile apps for the same. So do I need to again do the development for the same, creating multiple APIs and exposing to mobile teams so that they can make a beautiful UI? So if my data is already into API, then I don't need to worry about. So that's why I'm choosing decoupled solutions. So it is like you don't need to hit Drupal DB again and again, and which is like your page loading speed will be like increased by 10 times. So first is that. Second one is caching of APIs. So there are like multiple APIs for header, for footer, for page layout, and for block. You have multiple APIs. Suppose I'm talking about a single home page where I'm having a single slideshow, some components, then some you may also like component, trending non-component, then we have header footer. We can't have multiple API for a single page. First, I need to first hit this particular API that is for navigation. Then I need to hit for footer. Then again for trending no block. Then for slideshow. So there are multiple API I need to hit for a single page. So these multiple API can be cached into some other thing like in the Redis, so that you don't need to go to Drupal and Drupal is hitting a query to MySQL and showing the data. So that is lots of API into a single go. So if I am creating APIs in the first go, then obviously I don't need to create multiple REST APIs or JSON for a mobile, iOS or desktop version of the site. So in a single go, I can just create a JSON API that will be used by all the channels and my work is done. So you don't need to worry about for that. And fourth one is like if you are just exposing data. Look, I'm not working at the front end. I'm not like a Node.js or what we call it, React developer. So I just need to create content type. I just need to create JSON APIs, and I don't need to worry about the tweak thing because my front end is not into Drupal only. So it is like somewhere else, like in a React or in the Angular one. Okay. So fifth point is like same one. You don't need development time for your other channels, and you can pre-generate Drupal and kill it. So what does mean? So I'm having like 10,000 pages for a Drupal site, okay? And that are like I have created into Drupal and I saved somewhere into Drupal node or Drupal taxonomies. So what I can do from a particular microservices, I can create a microservices which can call this all API into a one go and store all the data into the Redis. So if I shut down my Drupal, the site will be working fine. So that is like pre-generate Drupal and kill it. So if you don't want to change the data, you just get all the APIs, store somewhere else, shut down the Drupal, and your site will be working fine. So it is the way how I works with Drupal. So let's move to decouple thing. Okay. So this is a diagram like which is showing why, when, how, what is need and what is static versus dynamic, what is coupled versus decoupled. So sometime if a client is coming, like client is saying, I just need to create a site of 7 pages, so which is like information pages. There is not much interaction. Then on this particular image, you can define like what is your need, what is editorial need, and which type of authoring you need. On the basis of that, you can choose type of solutions. Either you need a Drupal coupled, which I think for 4 to 5 pages, I think Drupal is fine. So you don't need to go to decoupled or headless solutions for the same. And if it is like more than 100 or 200 pages, and there are multiple APIs, you need to show the data. And I think for that, we have different type of solutions. So there is like a logical diagram, like what to choose and when to choose and how to choose. So this diagram is just created by Dries, and I just copy pasted from his blog only. So that is all about decoupled Drupal. So till the time, do you have any question? Okay. So this is like main thing that I will cover today. So there is multiple problems into Drupal decoupling. Okay. For Drupal decoupling, as you mentioned by Preston, like there is a problem into preview. So they are working on the same, like they are just saving the node, and on the other end they are just previewing it, how it will look like into the front end. Okay, so this is the one, and Apart from it, we have a multiple API for a single page, like as I told, like header, footer, and multiple blocks and panels on a single page. And there is, if we are hitting MySQL with a multiple APIs query, then there might be transaction lockout time. You have seen into the database logging, and there are sometime timeout error because a node is not saved, but we are fetching it from the front end. And there are workflow use cases. Then how decouple will work? Like if my content is into draft mode, or maybe into some other state, then how decouple will work? Okay. And Vue REST export with contextual filter. So what is a typical Drupal views? In the views, we can have like suppose a scenario. For a user one, I just want to show all the blocks which are related to user one only. So in that case, from the view, I can choose a contextual filter where I'm passing the user ID and I will get all the blocks. But that is not possible in decoupled Drupal because we are exposing an API. And CMS versus CMS. So that I will cover in the brief. Redirection of your old URLs. Have you seen that module, like redirect module into Drupal? So if you have old URL and you have changed into the new one, and it will easily 301 or 302 redirect to new URLs. But how it will work into like your front headless Drupal or decoupled Drupal? And similarly, page as a experience. Suppose I'm using a page which is having panels. So in the what is a panel like? In the panel, we can define the layout of a page, and we can place blocks according to that, and we can refer content taxonomy into that blocks. But how it will work in decouple things? Okay. Apart from, there are some modules like meta tagging. So how to handle the SEO of the pages. So that is again a challenge into decoupled Drupal. Sitemap, how you create a sitemap of the same, because all the URLs are not handled by Drupal. So it is based on the node or maybe React. And there are multiple points into that. Okay. So I will cover some of them today. Yeah. Suppose you are having a Drupal 7 site or Drupal 8 site, and it is like user slash 1 or user slash 2. On user slash 2, you just want to show blocks which are authored by user 2 only. So what you will do, you will just create a view, and you will just pass contextual filter, and where you pass user ID, and you get all the blocks. But how you will do with the decoupled Drupal? Because you don't know the URL parameters, routers, because that hit by the Node.js or maybe React app. No, that is one scenario. You can pass UID, but what are the data you are getting from an API? So we just need to create another API for the blocks only, which will render on the basis of user ID, okay? But in the Drupal, you just need to do the coding, okay? But in the Vue, it is very simple. You just pass the contextual filter and do it. But for the headless, you just need a user ID every time. So there might be, it's not user ID, it may be something else. It's maybe something as page ID, node ID. But that is not possible into Node.js. Because in the node, we are just hitting like blog slash blog title. Then the front end team will pass that title to me with the API, and then they get the data. But you need to do the coding for the same. But in the Vue, it is very simple. Create a display as a REST export, pass a contextual filter, and do the stuff. Okay. So this is the main thing. And again, there are some other things like filtering relationships, how you pass that. Okay. So that is the main funda. So I will just first cover the preview one. So what we have done to get the preview thing. Okay. So suppose this is my Drupal and this is my Node.js front end running. Okay. So maybe React one. So I'm saving a node and I just want to preview it. Okay. So that is not possible with the latest changes into decoupled. And if I just want to do that, what I will do, I will create another Node.js API or maybe React API. And if suppose I just want to open a page which is in the draft mode, so like that is in the latest revision of the particular node. So for now we have two apps. One is for publish app, that is my actual site, and second one is a preview site. So I have two instance of Node.js app, and in the first publish we are just passing in the query parameter I need type of article which is tagged to some tagging ID like a taxonomy term, and response type equal to publish. So what it will do, it will get the data from the node table, and you can see it into the published like your main native app of Node.js, React or Angular, whatever you are using at the front end. But if you just want to preview it, you need to create an app which is same API but with a response type equal to preview. So if in the API, if I'm getting a query param like a preview, instead of hitting my node table, I will go to node revision table, getting a latest revision of the table and getting a nodes data from there, and then I'm rendering from that. Okay, so it does not matter it is in which state, is a draft one, or maybe we can define our own stages like a review, QA review, something like that. So this is the way we can see drafted or latest data, and we can preview it with the another node app, React app. Okay, so this was the nodes the person was doing. So I just asked him like how to do it. So he just answered, you can create your custom solution. So this was the solution I am following that. Okay, so for preview you are getting your latest revision of the node or taxonomy, because right now taxonomy is also revisionable in Drupal 8. Okay, so and how you get to app now? So in the Drupal node there is a button called preview. Okay, in the preview you run time create a URL which will land you to the node preview app, and in the node preview app you have a click go back to CMS, and you can come back to the same CMS if you find everything is good. Now you can publish it, and if it is in published state, not in drafted or some other state, then you can directly go to this particular app that is published one, and you can get the latest view from there also. Okay, so is it clear like how we can do a preview and publish one? So this is the way we are following. Yeah, so making an bootstrap API. So what is it is? So I'm loading a page one, page two, home page, about us. Each time for about us page, I'm hitting my header, hitting my footer API, hitting my blogs content API, hitting my panel API. So for that particular page, some of the APIs are common, like header footer is on every page. Okay, so why I need to hit for the same on each page or each request or each router? Okay, for that I will do, whenever I'm opening a page, I'm creating a bootstrap call. So bootstrap is nothing, it just making a call to header plus footer plus all the page content in a single go. So we have used APG. APG is like API proxy layer. So if I pass any request like I give me the content of about us, so what it will do, it will just hit CMS and get the about us data plus header and footer API by default. So this is called bootstrap. If my header or footer API is down, my site will not open it. Okay, so it is like I'm making a bootstrap API, and similarly we can render multiple component which are on the like home page, about us page and taxonomy page, which are used like multiple times on multiple pages. So I can make a bootstrap API for the same. So this can like lower down your request. Like if for a single go I'm hitting a single API but I'm getting a full page content. So this is like making a bootstrap API. If bootstrap is down, that means your site is down. So, transaction lock and timeout error. So, if I am hitting CMS like, भाई मैं तो पागल हो गया हूँ. हर API, एक पेज के लिए 15 API हिट कर रहा हूँ. Drupal बोल रहा मैं डेटा कहाँ से लाऊँ? Because Drupal is getting data into cache tables. Okay, so they are cache beans into Drupal. So that data is stored into cache. So what we have done? We have created a micro services. That is nothing a Java code. Java code, and suppose I am having 5 pages in the whole site. First one is home, second one is about us, third one is like contact us, fourth one is different one. What we can do, I can create an API showing I have these many pages. So what these pages will do, it will just hit this particular API content question mark type equal to article, and where it will pass URL equal to slash home. So it will hit CMS with the parallel call, get all the data for home page, about us, contact us, okay, store into the Redis. So if I show you this way, so in the Redis we have a key value kind of thing. In the key I am storing data like this: API content type equal to blog, tag 1, tag 2, and in the value I'm having the JSON contract for the same. Okay, so each time a front end, the React team or the Angular team is not hitting actually Drupal, it is hitting Redis. Okay, in the Redis they are hitting a key and they are getting the data and showing at the front end. So there is no need of for the CMS for the same. So if the call goes to CMS, then CMS will hold bootstrap, and it will ask for authentication, and it will go for node tables and getting data from the same. But I will create an Java code or maybe a micro service which can just parallel hit to all the pages, storing as a key there as a query param, and its JSON contract into the value. So if my Drupal is down and if my I'm hitting directly to Redis and my site is up and running. So do you have any question on that? Like, yeah. It depend on the TTL. There's a TTL kind of thing when we can invalidate cache. Suppose for key 1 I'm having value 2, and but I have changed something into value 2, then how Redis know? So that I will come later on. And if I'm making a first entry on hitting my first time I'm hitting that will automatically do my entry into Redis table there. So any question apart from it? Yeah, we can use it, but I'm just showing my use case and how they. Okay, so that was the thing I was talking about. Create a separate API which is showing we have all these pages like slash home and slash something. Include all the URLs with the param. Suppose my params are this one: type equal to blog, tag equal to 1, tag equal to 2, and similarly we have different. Sometimes it is like content ID, API slash content, and node ID is equal to 3, something like that. And for that, I can create an API which is showing all the URLs and which will hit the CMS, storing, get the all the data and store it in the Redis in the form of key and value, and React directly interact with Redis. Okay, so that is okay with the static site. Okay, suppose I just want to create my own blog, or I just want to create my own my Devinder.in my site. Okay, where I hardly changes, so that is okay for that. But if I talk about e-commerce, or if I talk about blogging site where I'm doing blogging on the daily basis, and if I'm changing on the site with a huge number of nodes and taxonomy, then this will fail. This will not fail. We need to do something else for the data. So that's come a tool called Kafka. So Kafka or webhook. Okay, so Kafka is a tool that is a messaging tool that is used by most of the users like which are on the huge tracks like WCM and APG and microservices. So what is Kafka? Kafka is nothing like Kafka is like a messaging application. Suppose in the node one or in the page one, I have changed something. Then how Redis table know it is changed? Okay. So what is in the Kafka? Kafka is like module onto Drupal. You can search about it Kafka, and there is a like clean, clear documentation how to install into your Ubuntu or into LAMP stack. Okay, so it's having two functions. Okay, one is creating a message, second one is reading a message. Okay, so what if I'm changing a node? Okay, yeah, something like that. If I'm changing a node, and after saving a node, I just want to inform Kafka this particular node or home page or about us page has been changed. Okay, please update same on the Redis. Okay, so what I will do, I will just ask Kafka, I will pass all the params. Like this is node ID 1, which is type of article changed by me at time this. I will pass this particular JSON to the Kafka, and on the other side there is a Kafka listener who just consuming messages. On the one end, when I'm saving a node, I'm calling an Kafka service which is just saving a node and getting the data, which type of data has been changed, and pushing a message. On the other side, at the Kafka side, there is another service called listener which is just getting that message and hitting back to the CMS with the particular params. Suppose I am creating a message which is in the form of JSON and showing type the node I am saving, which is it is type of article, but is it is tagged with taxonomy term 9. So what Kafka service will do? Kafka service will read this particular message, hit this particular content API with param this type equal to article, which is tagged to ID equal to 9. So there can be number of articles over there. Okay, so it will hit that particular URL into Drupal, getting a JSON and store into this Redis view table. So that is the answer to your question. You are asking how I will update a thing. So Kafka is the great tool where you can store data and where you can pass message to Kafka, and Kafka service again can call to microservice which can hit the Drupal CMS and get the data stored into Redis. East and next time if front end person is hitting the particular page, they will get the latest data. Okay, if node title is changed, node body is changed, they will get is easily from the Redis only. So this is like how you do it. Or you can create your own API, like yeah, this one. So I was using AWS with S3 bucket service, and I have creating this custom shutdown handler. The benefit of this customer shutdown handler is like that, if Kafka service is down or Amazon service is down, you still able to save your node. Okay, some it's not like that. If Kafka server is down and you are getting an error, your node will be saved. After saving your node, you will get that function running, and if Kafka is up, you will get a message. Okay, so if we not do with the custom shutdown handler into Drupal, and you are doing it on node save, pre-save, up to date, or something else, then it might not save your node into Drupal. Okay, so there are some other hooks which is using post custom shutdown function that is post save hook, post what we call it, I don't remember, like post save hook, I know. So which is using the same function, custom shutdown. Okay, so what I am doing, so I'm hitting a particular API with the Drupal HTTP client, with that API path is API webhook cache bursting, type equal to dollar type is like no type I'm passing, key equal to something else, and unique key is like it is a slash home slash about us page or which type of page it is, and logging a message into Drupal. Okay, so what when I hit this particular API, it will call again a Drupal CMS getting latest data with this type of article with the key ID equal to this and unique key equal to slash home slash about us and store that data into the Redis. Okay, so there are two solutions for the same. One is Kafka, another one your own custom hook. So clear, this part is clear. So data I already discussed, what are the challenges based on user ID, how do you can use the relationship into views and how you can expose filter as a query param. Okay, so this one is like I'm creating a page which is like slash home into Node.js front end. Okay, but Node.js, but I just want to, when URL is equal to slash home, I want to do something else. I am getting this URL pattern. I just want to show my own photo on slash home, then how can I can do? So I need to create an API and the front end team is passing an URL equal to slash home. I'm getting this particular URL and on the basis of that I'm doing things. Okay, so that is not the good option, because but in the Drupal 7 or Drupal 8 it was very easy if we are using front end and back end both in Drupal. We are just hitting node router and we are getting node ID from that, and on the basis of node ID we are getting into a type of content type and we're showing data accordingly, but that is not possible with decoupled Drupal. Okay, so that is the main thing which you don't want to miss. CMS versus CMS. Okay, so first CMS is content management system, second CMS is configuration management system. Okay, and you are seeing this slideshow that is written title and image and subtitle and a read more button over there. Okay, so what I will do into Drupal, I will create a component or where I will showing title field, subtitle field, there is an image field and there is a read more, but I need another variation of the same. I just want to use same component, but read more button is on the right side. So how front end team knows how to render read more button on the right side on the next page? Okay, because component same. So in that case we are giving extra fields to this particular component where it is showing like CTA link or button link which is aligned left. So I can create a field which is type of a list type where I can mention alignment left or right. Okay, so it's like of a configuration. If I choose left, then button will be on the left side, and if I choose right, then React team just hit an API getting all the fields from there and then they store the data. So let me show you a demo for the same. So are you able to see? Yeah. So this is like our banner class. So how you can this is class which will be used by HTML team. So on the basis of that they can show something like that, and here is the URL. If you hitting that button read more or something like that, then where you will be landed. Okay, so where is field title, height, width, alt tag, something like that. And here is his type of link, but I just want to show it like a button. Okay, from the CMS I am just creating this field as a type of select list. I can choose there as a button, and here in the field C they will get like a button. Okay, now they know read more is not a link, it is a button. So on the basis of that they can do the theming CSS part. So I can call it this kind of a configuration into Drupal. It's not a content CMS, we are using it. Okay, and the same component I just want to use, like where I just want to, with the alt tag is different and height width is different, then I can mention on the same component will be used into another pages with the different attributes. Okay, you don't need to create your own component for the same. So this is kind of configuration that is read by front end team. On the basis of that they can do the CSS HTML according to that. Okay, so this is kind of a configuration, not like managing content only. So moving back. So yeah, assume. So like in Drupal 8, we have like module which is named as meta tag. So if we use that, we have fields like keywords, title, description, and when once we save it, is the code is easily embedded into the HTML, the source code of the page. But how we can do with that decoupling in Drupal? Okay, so for that, what we have done, we use paragraph module into Drupal 8, so through which I have created components which is based on SEO for Twitter that we call open graph. And apart from it, we have SEO item prop. So these all params are exposed through API and embedded through HTML. So let me show you. This is like field SEO, item prop. OG is for open graph, SEO for Twitter, and these all component we are using it, and we are passing data into that. And what front end team is doing, they are getting data from here and embedding into the HTML. So each page I'm having my SEO data that can be easily decoupled with the front end, and I can't lose my web traffic on the site. Okay. So, any question till now? Okay, so second one is read the direction module. So it is like my front end is into Drupal only. So previous to this particular Drupal version, my site page was like it was slash about or it was slash contact. But right now it is contact hyphen us. Then how I will redirect my new traffic to this particular URL, because Google has crawled only slash contact. Then how contact hyphen us will open? Okay, so for that we have Drupal redirect module. So that is okay to use it if we have a simple Drupal, not decoupled one. So how can we do would do it with decoupled Drupal? So for that, in the Redis there are some rules, but right now it is hard coded. Like I just need to give them the list that these pages has been changed. For that you need to write a custom code on the red on the node side, and then you can do the redirection. So that is not possible in Drupal 8. Okay, so this is again our team is working on the same. So page as experience. Okay, so suppose I'm just creating a simple page, home. Okay, on the home page or maybe about us page, and I have different components, different layout. Then how front end team knows? Could be if I talk in Hindi, भाई इस पेज पे तो ये वन कॉलम लेआउट था, बट मुझे टू कॉलम करना है, मैंने CMS से चेंज किया. बट हाउ फ्रंट एंड टीम नोज कि इसका कॉलम का लेआउट चेंज हो गया, वन से टू हो गया, एंड इट इज टू टू थ्री. ओके, so for that in Drupal 8 we have used panel thing. Okay, in the panels we are exposing layout of a panel, so I can give you this kind of thing. Okay, so this is what we call it, API for a single page, where in the CMS you can go to CMS, open any node. You can choose the layout, one column, two column, three column, and you can get layout as layout single, white region. You can define your own columns kind of thing in Drupal. Okay, so on the basis of this layout single white region, they have their own kind of HTML written on the front end, and they can show and can render data accordingly. And in after that there is a called there is key called reasons. So reasons like I on a single theme I have multiple reasons, like content reason, sidebar first, sidebar second, footer, header. Okay, but in the reasons first I have this component. Components is a key. Again I have params, a second param, third param. On this first reason I having three components. Okay, first one is marketing banner, if you see, and second one is multi-purpose story blocks, and third one is like hero modules. So it is not like it's kind of a banner kind of thing, and which is showing on a single page layout. Like it's not like recently into Drupal. It is with the AEM. Okay, but we have followed the same into Drupal with the help of panel, and you can easily find the way how you can change the layout of a page into Drupal and see the same into the front end layer. Okay, so similarly, the panel is very powerful tool, and we have like lots of coding effort to do it. So actually, the panel saving his data is like in the form of blobs. So we need to serialize the whole data and showing in the form of JSON. And each time if something changes, we need to do custom query and do the stuff. So this type of configuration or development we have done so far. So this is kind of how you change layout of a page and how you can change components on a particular region of a page. So I think that's all I just want to show. So I have covered preview multi-API for a single page. That was a bootstrap API. Third one is how you can save transaction log time, how you can use like what is the problem for the views, and how you can use CMS as a configuration management system where you can change the banner of a page and moving the button to left to right, changing the color of a banner, changing a background of a particular block, and how you can read direction of rules, how you can use page as an experience, how you can change the layout of a particular page with the panels, and how you can do the SEO of a particular page in the decoupled solution. And for sitemap, you just need to do the custom coding. Okay, so there is no solution for the same. And Preston and other folks like Gabber are working on the same, and there are little more problems into that. So yeah, so that I'm not moving, like I'm not like digging into coding part. I'm just giving the solution like how we have done it. And if you face any challenge, you can directly reach out to me. If you are giving any kind of placing any decoupled solution into Drupal 8, okay. So how you find it? बोलो भाई, कैसा था सेशन? ठीक था? ओके, सो इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चन रिगार्डिंग डिकपल और एनी अदर ड्रुपलेट हेल्प, आई एम ऑन दिस माई ईमेल आईडी, एंड यू कैन इजली फाइंड मी ऑन drupal.org. माई यूजर नेम इज स्नेही, SNEHI, एंड आई एम डूइंग कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑन ड्रुपल 8 एज वेल. सो आई एम हैविंग मोर देन 70 पैचेस इन टू ड्रुपल 8 कोर. ओके, सो इफ यू हैव एनी सजेशन, एनी सोल्यूशन और एनी क्वेश्चन, जस्ट रीच आउट टू मी ऑन ऑन दिस. ओके, थैंक यू एवरीवन.